radiofrequency ablation is a minimally invasive outpatient procedure in which we use image guidance, whether that's x-ray or ultrasound guidance, to place one or more needles next to a nerve and then use a small probe through that needle to heat that nerve and stop it from sending pain signals. This is usually a quick procedure within 30 minutes. It can be applied to multiple areas of the body. The most common we use it for are neck, thoracic, and lumbar spine. We also have treatments available for osteoarthritis of the knees and sacroiliac pain. So during a radiofrequency ablation, we usually use some sort of sedation to make you comfortable. Once we have you positioned and have decided on which x-ray guidance or ultrasound guidance is appropriate for that application, we clean the area of the body to sterilize the skin, minimize the risk of any infection. We obtain the proper images we need through x-ray or ultrasound. We then numb the skin to make placement of these RFA probes or radiofrequency ablation probes painless. Once the probes are in place, we usually do a series of testing to make sure that we are getting rid of the nerve that we are targeting and staying away from nerves that we don't want to damage. After we've done that testing process, we numb the nerve so that there's little to no discomfort during the actual ablation. The ablation itself usually takes about 90 seconds, plus or minus a few, depending on certain applications and techniques. Recovery from an ablation is usually minimal. Very infrequently do patients have to take extra time off of work outside of the day of their procedure. I do tell patients they can experience 24 to 48 hours of discomfort at the site, Tylenol or non-steroidals or ice packs or all that are needed to treat that pain. Oftentimes, whenever we complete an ablation, patients remain numb from the numbing medication that was given to make the ablation comfortable. And then by the time the numbing medication wears off, some patients have already getting the effect of heating that nerve and those nerves are no longer sending pain signals. In a select few patients, this pain can stay gone for sometimes years at a time. More often, we see patients that do get a substantial pain relief on the order of months. And as a wide range, I tell patients to expect relief on the order of 6 to 12 months. In certain areas like the low back, data does suggest that we are getting closer to 8 to 12 months, realizing that there are patients on both sides of that time range.